But at the end, it did answer. David said, "It took me from the miracle and set my feet upon the rock." I've shared mine with you. In the few moments that we have, let's share that. Let's hear. Anyway. Out of the mouth of beasts, as God ordained. So if the adult refuse to give praise, the child will give praise. Come on, brother.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I said, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I just thank you, Lord, for helping me with my education, making me get in a good secondary school.
Yes.
Because at the start of the year, I was hoping to get a really good secondary school, but I came into Cecil Jones. But God answered my prayers. But I went to Shrewsbury, but He still answered my prayers, and I went to St. Thomas Hall. Woo!
Yes, amen.
Praise God. I'm so happy for you. You're going to be a great man.
Yes.
Amen.
The Lord bless you.
He's doing very well in school. He's having good reports, and I'm very, very proud of him.
Oh. Was it on Sunday that I went to minister to the grandma in the house? And as I was going, his laptop was just playing up. You know, if you press key zero, it will give you key. You just press, and then he was meticulously writing all the wrong things down. That is, if you press P, it doesn't give you P, it gives you maybe 2. You write it down, thinking that maybe you can figure out the thing. But it's hard to even comprehend. So he said, "Pastor, do you know about this?" Because I just said, "Well, let's help." Then we look at it, and we just start to change the key part from maybe US, UK to another thing. And then it was there, it was more than I loved it. But I couldn't know what to do, you know. And I said, okay. Because I also had a diploma in programming. Just said, this was a piece, easy piece, easy. Just do it. So, and I was so happy, you know. So, because he was so dedicated and studious, he was there on his table and studying. Bible says, "See that a man diligent in his ways shall stand before kings and not before men." So the only thing we can thank God for, I mean, about our children is that even at home, I see my children, their A-levels, three of them, you know, figuring things out. In the middle of the night, I just walk past there. It reminds me of many years that I too did the same. It's interesting that those things you do not teach your children, they take after you. You just see yourself in them, and you can see them in their lives. You know, I see their mannerisms in their lives. I see how determined they are. Yesterday, Victor was studying in the table there, and so the phone rang. One of his friends called. Because he had been studying, his brain has been in different places. And by the time they called, for the first 2 minutes or so, my son was awake, but wasn't with us. He was still drowsy. I said, "God, look at this boy." And that reminds me also, is it, when your brain has been too much activity, you know? So good things. And then when they needed your attention, it was as if you are just in a state of stupor. You're there. So we had to give him some time for the sleep to go so that he can come. And then eventually he got there. So we need to thank God for our children. They're doing very well. I can say of my children as well. They're doing very well. And yesterday also, at the Bible study, before we start the Bible study in the house, morning devotion, I've already looked at a truck that was put on a weighing scale at the garage. And on that platform, there's a spring. The truck has to be in that spring. Every time the truck gets there, because it's spring, it has a weight, a And then it depresses the spring. Now they said, they've given you the weight in kilograms, and they now told you the depression, the distance you traveled in certain meters. And that reminds me of physics. And I stood there, and I wanted to challenge my son doing his upper six. I've already known the calculation quickly. I challenged him. Eventually he got there, Abraham. So you see, and the mom will say that, you still remember, you can never forget those things. Mm-hmm. So you can never forget. And that's why I challenge everybody in this place to read. You know, I studied hard for many years, left school about 40 years ago. I went back to do masters, you know, some 3 years ago, you know. And my wife also did the same thing. And I'm studying also, trying to find a way back into public health, you know, and then do so many things, you know. So pastor is not just there waiting for you to call him. I say, you still have work to do, you know. I have so many works, counseling, ministering, studying the Bible. So I want you to challenge yourself, as I've said, in this new year, which of the books of the Bible will you finish? I want to finish the Bible again 1 year. Why can't you finish it every day for the Lord? You will finish in 365 days. Somebody once said that if you read 4 chapters in a day of the books of the Bible, you will complete the whole Bible in 1 year. Easy peasy. So why don't you try it? The challenge is that many of us, we are not interested in it. We are not interested because we don't know God that much. And I'm begging you, if you are following me, as I'm following Christ, you have to study the Bible. I'm not a fake preacher. I'm a medical doctor. See? So I know book. Amen? I read books. See? And I want people to see that. So when you're comparing pastors, pastor is different from others. See? I have so many goals to achieve in this coming year. I've not come to my destination yet. See, I'm going far, and you are going far.
Amen.
See, and I encourage everyone to do very well in their chosen profession. Why not? So when you do well, I'm also doing well, and the work of God will prosper. You see, and when you know God, it's beautiful. Wherever God takes you to, He will pave way for you. 170-year-old man or so met Pastor Nicky some years back. He just was in the university, going back there to do things. He's not doing that to work. He just to keep the brain working. And the research have shown that if, for those elderly among us, that if you continue to study, you'll be free from dementia. Easy. If you are continuing studying, continue education, you are studying a book. You see, that's why I'm impressed by the elders sitting there and Les. They gave me a book that they are reading. And the good thing about this is that if people read books, good readers will be good leaders. If you don't read, you cannot lead. I've seen people in the church, they want to lead, but they are not readers. And that's the problem. This pastor knows everything, most things rather. Not only am I a doctor, I have a diploma in information technology. I have business qualification from business school. I do the accounting of the church. You see? What else? I did program in public health. You see? I have certificate in project management, Prince 2. So, what else? And I'm still looking for things to do. Because the day you stop doing something, developing your brain, start dying. It's the truth. That's why I'm challenging you. It's a shame many people are not here today. Study the book. As you are studying, you will grow more. People will come to you for information. The reason why many of you are not asking questions when I ask questions is because you are not confident in the word of God. When you do what I'm doing, you will ask questions. Please, can you make up your mind as we go to 2018? You want to finish the Bible. It's doable. 4 chapters in a day. You'll finish it in 1 week. And if you have any question, That is what I'm here for. You see? I'm even trying to go into the prison service where I can help them. Yeah. Telling you now. So God is going to raise a lot of people as leaders. And this year coming, I'm going to go into different countries to preach the word of God. And I want you to be aware of it. That when it's happening, you know. That's why I'm challenging us. Let's come for prayer meeting. Last week I said people should write down what how they can support me. No one came. It speaks volume. Because no, people are not interested in serving God. And it's a shame. It's a shame. That's the way. So it's not about sorry. It's about tearing your heart, not your garment. So I'm begging us. God is not a joker or a joke. He doesn't. He God is serious. He's a serious God. You know, one of the people that I respect in the Lord as well finished his bachelor's in law and also almost graduated of his master's in law, LLM. What about that? So never you think that by coming to church you are doing pastor favor. You are doing yourself a favor. But when God bless you, blesses me. You know? But if you are not doing yourself a favor and you are not ambitious, even at old age or some age at all, then the people that God wants you to bless, to reach out to, you will not be able to reach out to them. People of your age, in our streets, you know, in our neighborhood. That's why I need support of the elders in this church. There are people that are dying in their homes, in their houses. And not until we go out and reach out to them, you know, we will not know. Hallelujah. Amen. Please, this is a living church, not a dead church. I will worship, let's worship alive. You know, when I press the ground, I can be come down. I beat everything. Yes. Even this one. I beat it. I started playing the keyboard.
Yes, long time.
Long time. I'm still doing it now. And I sing. It's to challenge you that you cannot put God in the ransom. If you are supposed to do anything, do it. I can man the door. I've opened the door today. I told you the testimony about how I opened the door. Because a lady came during the Christmas time and said, it's good for us to open the door. God told her. And that's it. So, guys, come early. Come early. It just started for 9:30. Come early. Because the time will come whereby most of us will not find a place to sit in this church.
Amen.
And it's going to come this year.
Amen. In the name of Jesus.
And then those that are coming late, you just find that there's no room. You have to come for another service. And God is telling me that this place shall become a youth church.
Amen.
A youth building.
Amen.
So, do we have the money? Well, we live in God. We live in God. So that we can take that mosque.
Amen.
And you know what I've been saying that?
Yes.
And turn it back to church.
Amen.
God, if God is God, he will do it. That's the vision.
Amen.
So don't compare yourself with anybody saying we're going to church. It's a different church. This one's a living church.
That's true.
It's a church that is purpose-driven. Purpose-driven what? Church. And the people worshiping God there must be purpose-driven. Amen. Testimonies will come this coming year.
Amen.
Testimonies will come. So get ready.
Amen.
Get ready to challenge one another.
Amen.
So does anybody have testimony? It's just pastor that is talking. Others are just spectacular. Somebody said before I go to Russia, he said there are three people in the church. Those that are saying, what's happening there? Is anything up? And the second people are the people that they are the ones that make things happen. see. They make things up. And the others are just, they're just there. They're just there. So where are you? You can see what pastor will be doing. He make things happen. I challenge my daughter. I challenge it. That's it. I'm a motivator through the help of God. And things happen in my life, I told you. It's all by testimony you are hearing. If anyone that give testimony is because they are part of the people that make things work. I'm telling you, make up your mind. Stop being a spectator. That's the first group. Let me see whether this was going to fall down to me. Oh, that sister is wearing a nice shoe. They're just observing. Yes, nice shoe. They're just observing. You know, don't be like that. When we come to God, just forget about yourself. I'm telling you. That's why I forget about people. I just focus on God. Yes, brother, person. Which group do you belong to?
The active. The doing group.
You will know. I'm telling you, you will know. Because God will do it through you. It is God that is working in us. Isn't it? What is will and don't do. So when things happen, it's God's, not me, it's God. I'm just being used as a vessel. Go on, brother.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It's just a testimony of thanksgiving for God's deliverance. He said he has delivered, he's delivering,
yes.
And he will deliver. Yesterday, today, and forever, he is the same. With my family, there was a lot of challenges.
Tell me.
2017.
Yeah.
There were a lot of up and downs, relational, children, travel, job, but each step of the way, and one rise to the Lord. He comes in. And just one time, he makes a way for us.
Yes.
But one particular one is deliverance from misfortune, accident. Before the beginning of December, the Spirit was speaking, pray for deliverance. Pray for deliverance. Deliverance from misfortune, mishaps, accident. And I told my wife, this is what God is asking us to pray about. He delivered us through our international travels. We had over 4 travels out of this country in 2017, by air, by road, whatever means. When France, I had the opportunity to drive around in France on our own, and it was only by the grace of God. He was with us, there was no misfortune. We went to Nigeria, the same thing happened. On the road, we witnessed serious accidents. But because we prayed that prayer of deliverance, he took us and brought us back to London safely.
Amen.
And then December was coming, and the Spirit was like, that is the period where the devil strikes. He has a lot of evil. And I believe in the news all around us, we've heard, misfortunes, people dying through crashes, accidents, fire left and right. So the Spirit kept me praying. This week, I was sleeping in the morning, and my wife usually goes out to a hospital appointment and then to the gym. She went to the gym, and I was like, she's taking too long to come back after the hospital appointment. And I phoned her up, and she said, I reversed into another car. I was like, thank you, Jesus. Because we've been praying for deliverance. Yeah. I believe that was what God did. It could have been something different or serious. She could have gotten out of that place on the main road. Mm. It would have been very fatal. Mm. But it was within the car park. Yes. There was some damage. The first thing I asked is, everyone okay? They said, yes, everybody's fine. I said, thank God. Because that's the main thing. Yeah. And I want to say that as a testimony, to say when we pray for deliverance, God really goes ahead of us. Yeah. What would have been serious, damaging, God puts his hand there. The back taillight is damaged. The body part of the back is damaged. But we thank God it's not a damaged life. We are alive. And we want to give God the glory and the honor for his deliverance. Thank you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ is wonderful, you know. Wonders and signs are very present in his ministry. In Acts chapter 2, verse 43, I'm just using it as a notice of what God wants to do for us in the new year. In Acts chapter 2, verse 43, it says, "And many wonders and signs were done through the apostles." And the signs, and that signs and wonders may be done through the name of your holy servant Jesus. Verse 30. So you can see that even through the hands of apostles, signs and wonders were done. So it was not only limited to apostles, even the deacons. Acts chapter 6 verse 8, we are also told, Acts chapter 6 verse 8, that Stephen, full of faith and power, did great wonders and signs among the people. And even in the Old Testament, we are told that the prophet Isaiah saw it and said in Isaiah chapter 8 verse 18, Isaiah chapter 8 verse 18, he said, "Here am I, and the children whom the Lord has given me." Can we read it together? "We are for signs and wonders in Israel from the Lord of hosts who dwells in Mount Zion." So that means that me and you, we are for signs and wonders in this land. See yourself that you are for signs and wonders. Even Jesus said in Mark chapter 16, verse 17, "And these signs will follow them that believe." So how many of us believe? You and I will believe. That's why we're here. That's why we are called believers. He says signs and wonders will follow us. So to really experience these signs and wonders, the Lord told me that every third Friday of the month, from 2018, we shall be having what is called a night of wonders. We are not going to collect offering, no collection. We are only going to come, pray for miracles, pray for progress, pray for salvation, pray for healing. You are going to tell your families and friends, even yourself, and I'm going to involve the ministers, the leaders, the elders, the choir, the instrumentalists, everyone, just for 1 hour. Let's come, and if the Lord extends it beyond 1 hour, that's fine. Let's come for signs, a night of wonders. What that means is that we're going to be looking at wonders of God. And I know that faith calls those things that be not as though they are. When we look at the wonders that God has done for people, we will now implement it in our own lives. And then God will leave God to do it. It might be that same night that people will receive miracles. It might be that same month, we don't know. But what the Lord tells me is that if we all support this, and give me 1 hour or two of your time on that third Friday of every month from 7 p.m. here. If I have that, we'll pray and other people from outside will come. Amen?
Amen.
So every third Friday, therefore, I'm challenging us to come. Joshua said in Joshua chapter 3, verse 5, he says, Joshua chapter 3, verse 5, he says, "Sanctify yourselves. Set yourselves apart, for the Lord will do wonders among you." So a night of wonders is a night whereby we set ourselves apart. For what? Wonders.
Wonders.
Easy. What night is it? A night of wonders. So yours might be there. This is where some people will pray. We are also going to be a night that is of prayer, a night that is of worship, a night that is of praise and a night that which God will perform wonders among us. Amen?
Amen.
So we shall set ourselves apart for the Lord to do wonders. So if you desire the wonders and signs, please invite families and friends. Mark it down with every third Friday of the month until God stops us. The front doors shall be open. We are not going to come through the ground. Because according to the word of that woman said, the place must be open. So the front door on third Fridays shall be open. Every other Friday we'll close it. Because we are not expecting outsiders. But this night of wonders, a night of wonders is going to be evangelistic. So I need the choir, I need the instrumentalists, it's very important that we welcome the Lord. So mark it down in your diary. Diaries is very important. And the power of the Lord, Luke chapter 5 verse 17, Luke 5:17, and the power of the Lord was present to heal them. The last verse there. The power of the Lord was present to heal them. Where you sanctify yourself for healing, the power of God comes there. It's going to be the tabernacle for healing. Every third Friday. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Well, what do we have today? Very simple. Hebrews chapter 11, verses 1 to 3. Hebrews chapter 11, verses 1 to 3. Are you with me?
Yes,
yes
sir.
Hebrews chapter 11, verses 1 to 3. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For by it, by what? By faith, the elders obtained a good testimony. By faith, we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that the things which are seen were not made of things which are visible. This is what faith is all about. That the things which are seen were not made of things which are visible. By faith. The things you desire to see, the things you now see, were not of this world. They did not originate from this world. The things which are seen were not made from the things which are visible. By faith, the things which do appear comes from the word of God. And the things you want to appear in your life will come from where? The word of God. Verse 3. By faith, we understand. This is what faith makes us to know. That the worlds were framed by the word of God. Everybody say, the word.
The words
were framed. By the word of God.
By the word of God.
So the words that you see, the physical world, is framed not by physical things. To be framed means that manufactured, called to being. So the things of the world, which are physical, did not originate from nature or nurture from nature. The things which you see, amen?
Amen.
Were not made from the things which are visible. They were framed by what?
The word of God.
The word of God. So the word of God can frame things. The word of God can frame things. If it framed the world, it can frame your own world. Get it right. How would this be, Lord? It can only be, not by the things you see or the things that are made, it can be only by the word of God. By faith. So, if you know the word of God, it can frame your world. Simple. By faith. And this is the last message for the year, as we go into the new year. The title is By Faith. Verse 2. For by faith, the elders obtained a good testimony. A good testimony is the product of the word of God. So, if you desire a good testimony, for there to be a good testimony, what does that suggest to you? There's also a bad testimony. But a good testimony is the product of what?
The word of God.
So it's up to you. Verses 4 to 5. By faith, Abel offered to God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain. You know that story, don't you? Mm-hmm. By faith, Enoch was taken away so that he did not see death. So when my brother was saying that God told them to pray against mishaps, it's the scripture. Verse 5. By faith, Enoch was taken away so that he did not see death. Before death comes, I have good news. God will have taken you away from him.
Amen.
That's what happened. By faith. Look at verse 7. By faith. Everyone say by faith.
By faith.
There's so many things you can achieve by faith. And I have no doubt you will achieve
them. Amen.
By faith. By faith, Noah, being divinely warned of the things not yet seen, God said, I'm going to destroy the world. Get yourself prepared. Prepare an ark so that you and your family will find a place to live. So he was warned in advance. Just as my brother said here, God warned them. You think God will open his eyes and allow evil to come to you?
No.
Say, no evil shall befall you, neither shall any plague, cancer, unknown diagnosis. See? What do you call those unknown diagnoses again? They are just unknown. But doctors call them. What do you call them again? I forgot. Unknown.
Yes.
I think it's big for yourself. Unknown. But when you say unknown, it's unknown. That is, God knows. But we don't know. In the medical school that I went, they say, it's God that heals. Me, I'm just a carer. See? So we know it's God that heals, isn't it? So by faith, Noah, being warned of things not yet seen, of the disaster to happen, God warned them. But Noah believed. So he prepared an ark for the saving of his household. By faith. Everyone said by faith.
By faith.
These elders obtained a good report, a good testimony. So, what sort of testimony do you want as this year, New Year is coming? The way you lay your bed is how you lie on it. And I see Pastor Nikki when she lays the bed, but some people are so tired to lay the bed. So when she lays the bed, that's the same way you are going to lie. You know? So how are you laying your own bed? It's very important. As years, New Year is coming. Because guess what? I can only take you to where I've been taken. Neither can you take anyone to where you have not been taken. Jesus Christ sent his disciples 2 by 2, according to Luke chapter 10, verse 1, where himself wanted to go. The reason why you find yourself where you are now is because God has been there. And where he is going to take you is because he is going to go there. And as long as you follow him, you will get there. So it's important how, what testimony you want in this new year. I have good news for you, therefore. It shall be a good testimony.
Amen. Amen.
The word of God can frame things. So if the word of God can frame things, then the earlier I get to grasp with the word of God, the better for me. Because God will not do anything that concerns you independent of you. God will do things that concerns you with your cooperation. He doesn't force himself on us. So, the word of God can frame things. Do I get an amen?
Amen.
Amen.
You agree with that?
Yes, sir.
Because the word of God says in John chapter 1, verse 3, John chapter 1, verse 3, said, all things were made through him, and without him, nothing was made that was made. Can you say that with me? Without him, nothing was made that was made. And here is it. Nothing was made that was made without the word of God. So the word of God can frame things. So the earlier you understand the word of God, and you become studious to divide time for the word of God on a daily basis, if you read 4 chapters of the Bible in a day, you will finish the whole Bible in 1 year. So if you want to know it, you will know it. Because without him, nothing was made that was made. So the word of God is in everything created. And the word of God will be in everything that you want to create. In fact, the word of God has a creative power. Because without the word of God, nothing was made that was made. Whatever God does, I know, shall be forever. Nothing can be added to it, and nothing can be taken from it. Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 14. Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 14. And God does it that men should fear him. So if what God does cannot be changed, unchangeable, unstoppable, unshakable, if what God does cannot be altered, what about what God had promised? What about what God had said? Forever, O Lord, your word is settled in heaven. Your faithfulness endures to all generations. You establish the earth and it abides. They continue this day according to your ordinances, for all are your servants. Psalm 119, verses 89 to 91. Psalm 119, verses 89 to 91. They continue this day what God has said. said by his word into existence. For the words were framed by what?
The word
of God. They continue till now according to your ordinances. For all are your servants. Everyone submits to God. Without him, nothing was made that was made. By faith. Everyone say by faith.
By faith.
So what Abel, Enoch, and Noah, and others, other elders, God knows the elders by name. That's why he put their names there. You see, uneasy lies the head that wears the crown. What Abel, Enoch, and Noah, and others did by faith was according to the promises of God. By faith, the elders obtained what? A good testimony. By faith, they simply fall in line with the word of God and obtained a good testimony. Without you falling in line with the word of God, you cannot obtain a good testimony. Thinking that you can do it on your own is just a futile effort. There is someone listening today, you will obtain a good testimony.
Amen.
By our what?
By faith.
For the just shall live by his faith. Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 4. Thank God he didn't say you will live by my faith. Neither will I live by your own faith. He said, for the just shall live by what?
His faith.
Everyone shall live by his faith. Faith is a sustainer. Sustainer. Faith will sustain you. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. By faith. He who believes in the Son has everlasting life. And he who does not believe the Son shall not see life. John 3:36. John 3:36. By faith. Everybody say by faith.
By faith.
Do you get an idea about faith? That faith is so pivotal to our sustainability here on earth? Do you believe that faith is so key to you and I pleasing God? Do you believe that? Rather than complaining that God, when will you answer my prayer? What you need to concern yourself is to keep the word of God. By faith. Faith is the only thing that can make you to have a good testimony. So as we go into the new year, have faith. Understand what faith can do in your life with God. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. I ask her to come out, despite his own truth. Because if we believe God for healing, healing will not take place until you put action into faith. It is true you have the pain, but you still believe God. And you do as if there is no pain. And then you see that the devil will be shamed, as always. I said the devil will be shamed in your life.
Yeah.
How?
By faith.
But without faith, it is impossible to please him. Do you want to please God?
Yes.
How?
By faith.
And that's what we explain. Because you cannot please God by logic. You cannot please God by bribing Him. You cannot please God by lip services. You cannot please God by high services. You can only please God how?
By
faith. And that is where the conundrum lies. If you want to be in His good books and obtain a good testimony, then faith in His word is what you need. God cannot be pleased without faith in His word. And that's why the pastor is always telling you, you can study the Bible in 1 year, 4 chapters a day. As we are going to the new year, you can, if you want to please God, it has to be by how?
Faith.
By faith. By faith, the elders obtained a good testimony. So, without faith, it is impossible to please Him. For he who comes to God must do what?
Believe.
Must believe. If you don't accept what He said in the Bible, then you don't believe. True or false?
True.
For he who comes to God must believe. Begin to take His word very seriously. Because His word can frame what? Your world. Whatever you desire can be framed by the word of God. If it framed the physical world, then it can frame your own world. And that's where the bottom line is. For he who comes to God must do what?
Believe
that he is. Moses said to God, indeed, when I come to the children of Israel and say to them, the God of your fathers has sent me to you, and they say to me, what is his name? What shall I say to them? Moses was asking God. And God said to Moses, in Exodus chapter 3, verses 13 to 14. Exodus chapter 3, verses 13 to 14. 14 says, and God said to Moses, I am who I am. Thus you shall say to the children of Israel, I am has sent me to you. So what's the name of God?
I am.
For he who comes to God must believe that he is. He is what he says. Take the word of God as he says it. Amen?
Amen.
He who comes to God must believe that he is. He is what he says. Take the word of God as he says it. Take the word of God literally, just as it says it. On top of it, take the word of God figuratively. Go on and do what he says. Amen.
Amen.
Do you get it?
Yes.
That's how it works for you. For what God has done is forever. Mm-hmm. Nothing can be added. Nothing can be taken. And if what God has done cannot be altered, what about what He has said? It's unchanging. By faith. For evil comes, Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6. For evil comes to God, must do what?
Believe
that he is, and that he is. Can you see? Twice. That he is, and that he is. He's unchangeable. Believe that he is, and that he is. Who is he? Who is he? Who he is? He is. He said, believe that he is, and that he is. So he is. He is, literally speaking. He is, figuratively speaking. He not only tells you what he wants you to do, he tells you what you should do also. You see? And that is where you take the word of God as it says, and then you also take the word of God to do it. He is, and that he is a rewarder. Everyone say rewarder.
Rewarder.
That suggests to me he rewards of those who diligently seek him. One day, a woman who had been smelling of her own blood because she had a blood disorder for 12 years. The Bible said that she had suffered many things from many physicians, and she has spent all. There are conditions in life that leave us empty. I have good news for some. By faith, the condition will stop today.
Amen.
So, when she heard about Jesus, she came and touched his garment. And immediately, the fountain of her blood dried up. And she felt in her body that she was healed of her affliction. Mark chapter 5, 25 to 29. Mark chapter 5, 25 to 29. The same faith is available today. The faith that healed that woman of her affliction. In Psalm 107, verse 20, Psalm 107, verse 20, he sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destructions. By faith, this woman's condition improved. Because when she heard about Jesus, she came. He that comes to God must do what?
Believe
that he is, and he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. So, by faith, your condition in this new year will change.
Amen.
If you believe that, say, I believe.
I believe.
By faith.
I believe.
Today we now know the association between wealth and health. But in the olden days of Naaman in the Bible, we learned that wealth cannot buy health. He was wealthy but not healthy. Today, many are not healthy even though they are wealthy. You know the woman that spent all, rather than the condition getting better, it got worse. The woman with the issue of blood. That means she was wealthy, but not healthy. But she spent all. Even the wealth finished. And there was still no solution. That means that God is the healer. I have good news for you. In this new year, God the healer will rescue you.
Amen.
For I am the Lord who heals you.
Amen.
Exodus chapter 15, verse 26. Exodus chapter 15, verse 26. By faith, you too will get healed.
Amen. Amen.
Because when Naaman found out that God is the healer, you know what he did? He came, he repented, and he came to God seeking for help. And they didn't go back the same.
No.
God healed him of his leprosy. 2 Kings chapter 5, verses 1 to 14. 2 Kings chapter 5, verses 1 to 14. Naaman believed. He believed God. He that cometh to God must believe that he is. And he is. He must believe that he is. He is what he says. He is. He is what he says he can do. So take his word as he says, literally. And take the word of God figuratively, because that's what he says he will do. So in other words, as you take it literally as he says it, also take it figuratively to do what he says. See yourself doing it. That's what it means. Figuratively. See yourself doing it. There's no point in just saying, yeah, I know. So, if you know, why don't you do it? That was the problem of that man in John chapter 5. He was at the pool of Bethsaida. He had been in that condition for how many years? 38. So it's not that he did not know that God can heal. He knew it literally, isn't it? But he failed because he did not put it into action. And Jesus Christ came, was up front. Excuse me. Why are you lying down when you're supposed to move? I have no one to carry me. God doesn't want you to depend on people. He wants you to depend on him. Because God is the healer. So I have good news for you. In this new year, God will heal you of your affliction.
Amen.
How?
By faith.
So one day, a widow in Zarephath with her son were so poor that their last meal was the only one keeping them from death. Have you explained that? Poorer than the poorest. Or the poorest of the poor. Poorest of the poor. The reason why I'm describing this with pictures is that you can see that God is with us. He knows what you are going through. If you are open to him, he will help you. So, this widow of Zarephath, she came just like you are here today, by listening and watching, to find out what can God do? This is my scenario. This is my case. I've heard so much about God, but can he help me? Now, he that is already fallen has no fear of fall, isn't it? God is already fallen. So I am already fallen now. Okay? Now, God, can you pick me up? Is that not a good inquiry?
Yeah.
Talk to me.
Yeah.
Maybe you are listening today, or you are here, you are in a hopeless situation. If you believe just like this woman did, then your condition will change. In 1 Kings chapter 17, verses 8 to 16. 1 Kings chapter 17, verses 8 to 16. The prophet said to her, "Woman, do not fear, because the first attack of the devil is fear. He will throw fear at you. And your defense should be, do not fear. Because God said, I will never leave you nor forsake you." This woman was experiencing famine. But the good news is that she never remained the same. Verse 15 to 16. Verses 15 to 16. So she went away and did according to the word of Elijah. And she and he, Elijah, and her household ate for many days. The bin of flour was not used up, nor the jar of oil run dry, according to the word of the Lord, which he spoke, which God spoke by Elijah. There is someone here. If you will do according to the word of the Lord that God is speaking by me, by faith, you will not die.
Amen.
But shall live.
Amen.
That condition, as bad as it is, cannot get, if there is a word to say, badder than that. It cannot get worse than that. But God is in the business of changing things.
Amen.
By faith, I speak to your condition. It will improve.
Amen.
Hebrews chapter 4, verse 2. Are you getting something?
Yes, Lord.
By faith. It's the last message of the year. You need to get it as you prepare for the new year. For indeed, Hebrews chapter 4, verse 2, the gospel was preached to us as well as to them. The same message preached. Not everyone that heard it gets a good testimony. But that will not be your portion.
Amen. Amen.
The same message was preached to us as well as to them. So the difference is in faith. What you are going to do. Both literally and figuratively with what you have heard right now. But the word which they heard. Everyone said they heard.
Yes.
You are hearing it.
Yes, Lord.
And you are hearing it too.
Yes, Lord.
But the word which they heard did not profit them. No. So you better stop sleeping or drowsing. Because the angels of the Lord are moving around. But the word they heard did not profit them. So the word is profitable. But the word did not profit them. How can the word of God profit some people and not profit the others? And not profit others. How can the word of God profit some and not profit others? Is the question, isn't it?
Yes.
To be or not to be? That is. Why will they profit some and not profit others? That is the question. Turn to somebody and say, that is the question.
That is the question.
Why? Because not being mixed with faith in those who heard. That's why I pity some people going up and down. Not being mixed with faith in those that heard it. When Naaman mixed with faith, what he heard, that God can heal him. He had earlier gone away furiously, isn't it? But when he knew that this is the chance, what did he do? He came back. And did God not heal him?
Yes.
They mixed with faith what they heard. I believe you too will mix with me what you are hearing.
Amen.
And your life will get better.
Amen.
In good testimonies.
Amen.
When the woman with the issue of blood mixed with faith, what she heard, before she wasn't there. Jesus Christ was there. But when she heard about Jesus, she came. And she said in her own house, if I may touch his garment, I shall be made whole. And that was exactly what she did. She came to church with a purpose. Many people come to church without praying. Many people come to church without seeking the face of God. She came prepared. This is what I want the Lord to do for me today. When the widow of Sarephath, who was the poorest of the poor, when she did what Elijah told her, when she did according to the word of God spoken by God through Elijah, isn't it? Our condition changed. Remember that. By faith. She did not die after. So don't go by that diagnosis. You will not die.
Amen.
You shall live.
Amen.
By faith, the elders obtained a good testimony. So lastly, what testimony do you want? Because I could see many people say, time has gone. I know. I'm still going to preach tonight the word God says. But this message has to come. Can we pray? What testimony do you want? With the heart, man believes unto righteousness. And with your mouth, confession is made unto salvation. Romans 10, 9 to 13. Romans 10, 9 to 13. Everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. God wants to save you, even as we go into the new year. Are you a sinner who must be saved today? By God. Is a death sentence on you because of the diagnosis? Is your condition so bad that you know that only God can help you? I want you to pray. I am here, Lord. I am for signs and wonders. I want you to help me. I'm here, Lord. I surrender all to you. Please save me. Jesus Christ told that woman caught in the very act of adultery. Woman, where are those accusers of yours? Said they've gone. Jesus Christ said, neither do I condemn you. Go and sin no more. Please call unto the name of the Lord to save you. By faith. I've tried to describe the paint the picture of you. I don't know where your condition is. But you know as well as God knows. As we go to the new year, what are you going to do? By faith. What testimony are you going to have by faith? Please ask the Lord. Call unto him to save. Give your heart to him. Ask him to forgive you of sins. Ask him to write your name down in his book of life. Ask him to give you a new heart. Ask him to save you.